We're here with Ronal Serpas, the superintendent of the New Orleans Police Department. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Mayor Landrieu just recently released his State of the City address. Tell us about the state of the police department.
Things are good. We've been able to complete our reorganization so that we've streamlined the top of the department to allow us to focus more energy and effort on accountability, violent crime, quality of life. We've got some very exciting plans that we're going to be announcing in the near future about how we're going to be attacking violent crime on several different levels, to include partnerships with the district attorney, Mr. Cannizzaro and his team, Newell Norman and the sheriff's office, and all these different agencies that we work with every day. Our message is clear. We're going to get through this year. We're going to work through this budget that's in front of us. And when we reach the 2011 budget, we will be able to say, this is what we think it costs to run this police department, and then we'll run it. I've been the chief of a police department for 9 years, and I've never overspent a budget. But I've always had a realistic budget that was based on facts, that was based on experience, that was based on the ability to manage real money.
Now tell us about this budget that you've now acquired. Tell us about the deficit, what you're having to deal with, what your spending budget is right now.
Well, the police department's budget was probably structurally flawed from the very beginning, and then added on to that was probably a lack of attention to detail on some of the overtime issues. What we've tried to do is recognize that, look, we came in May, all of us did, and we're going to work with what we have, and we're going to continue to provide service. We're going to continue to make sure we answer the radio. We're going to continue to expand what we want to do to make New Orleans a safer city. We're not going to let this get in our way. We're going to deal with it. We're going to make it happen, and we're going to move forward.
And so also tell us, you've made a significant number of layoffs, should say, a couple of weeks ago. So tell us about that.
Well, part of the problem was, and just quite honestly, I don't look backwards, I look to the future, but one of the problems was clear that 23 people were hired that there was no funding authority for. There was no funding anywhere to be found for that. And unfortunately, these were hardworking people who we just could not keep. There's nothing we could do about it. It's a sad thing to have to go through, but there's nothing we could do about it. There were some other employees who we really hoped that they would have done better, but at the end of the day, we probably thought it was better for them to look for another career and better for us if they looked for another career. So we had to make those decisions. It was about 49 or 50 people. We understand what happened to them and their families, but we have a responsibility and a duty to spend the money that we're given. We cannot overspend. Cities are not like the federal government. You got a dollar, you spend a dollar. You can't spend a dollar and make five more. So we have to work with what we have.
And none of those individuals were actually police officers. So are you still looking at, are we okay in terms of the number of police officers that we have right now, or do we need to hire more?
I think what we have to do is get a better understanding of what we have. One of the things I've asked the Department of Justice to help me with is to provide some funding for analytic tools that other police departments in America used to really understand what should be the workforce. Here in New Orleans, God knows I love our community, but we're still handling police assignments like we did 30 years ago when I came here. And there's a lot greater techniques and analytical software that you can use now, and we need to get that so we'll know exactly what the box should be filled with.
Ronal Serpas, thank you for that.